These are difficult financial times, and reducing store shrink to recover lost profits has never been more important. In fact, proactively reducing store shrink is likely to be your most direct route to real profit improvement, competitive advantage, and survival. This information-packed video series by Larry Miller is entitled The Total Store Manager. Larry is the recognized loss prevention authority, and in this series, he will reveal to you a wealth of valuable tips and techniques that you can start using now to reduce and even eliminate the shrink losses that are robbing your bottom line. Don't miss any of the 14 segments that will be presented right here. Then plan to bring Larry in for a live, upbeat, and highly productive store manager training workshop at your company. This segment covers cashier theft and errors, the cause of more than 60% of the shrink in most supermarkets. Smart managers will discover the importance of being more front-end engaged, then learn how to employ the proven techniques that will stop these problems.
Let's talk about cashier shrink for a minute. It's one of my favorite topics because I believe more shrink is lost at the front end than any other single point within the store. Every single dollar of profit, every single dollar of cashier theft translate to big dollars for you. Every single sale and every single dollar of profit on its way to the bank must be handled by a cashier unless you're diverting, right? Because even if you're buying smart, the way we make money in grocery is to buy smart. The way we make money in perishables is to sell fast. But every dollar made at retail has to come through a cashier. I believe that if you can see it, you can control it. A manager has to have targeted front-end key performance indicators that he or she must monitor on a regular weekly basis, constant and consistent with absolute certainty. He or she has to know what to look for. He or she has to know how to preempt shrink, because shrink is easy to preempt, just like shoplifting. I can cut shoplifting in half in any store in a matter of minutes. It doesn't take a camera. Cameras are for slip and fall, and you should use them for some sort of deterrence from other people, but it's really a slip and fall thing in my mind, because I've proven through interviewing of shoplifters that they don't care whether you have cameras or not, because they don't think you use them. He or she has to know how to preempt. But we also have to know how to measure and progress toward known goals. So one of the things we know we can use is electronics. We can use data mining. We can also use Excel. We can also use any kind of a shrink tracks type report, even though that's not marketed that way anymore. We can also use a yellow pad, if that's all we have. So there's nothing standing in our way of writing down the key performance indicators for cashier performance that will reveal theft probabilities or shrink probabilities. Now, most of you know I owned and operated shrink tracks for 17 years. That company's been sold. But my point that I teach everybody is this is not about catching people stealing. This is about preventing shrink. That's what it's about. There's just as many errors and mistakes made at the front end as there are theft incidences. It's just that the theft incidences are measured in hundreds of dollars, and the errors are measured in generally less than $10 or $15. It's like a coupon. You know, that coupon story that was told by Bob Robert, right? It can add up, but it's not in multiples of hundreds. So we must have a report that reveals to us our key performance indicators. How many of you have a weekly report that you review on cashier performance as it relates to shrink prevention? Okay. You do, Bob, or don't? Was that a hand halfway up, or were you just going to your pen? Okay, good. Everybody must have something, right? It's a gaping hole. If you don't have a front-end control program, it's a gaping hole in your system. Because with an automated cashier performance monitoring system or any kind of cashier performance monitoring system, we can get to the point where we actually communicate effectively, proactively, preemptively with the cashiers whose performance is not up to store par, whatever that means in your store. Shrink numbers at the front end, more than any other department, rely on the DNA of that store. right? You have a beach store versus a city store. The buying mix, the selling mix, the customer population, everything is different. Every store has its own front-end statistical key performance indicator, DNA. That's why we measure it at the store level. And we make sure that we're following all the right rules and all the right things for our unions and all of our employees, and we sit down with the cashiers and we tell them when they're underperforming store norms. So when it comes to the front end, it's a very brief section for me, because if you don't have it, and you guys do, but it seems like most don't, the first thing we have to do is get it, right? Cashiers have to know that they're being monitored. It's not wrong. It's not a club. It's not a threat. It's not Big Brother. It's a business management tool that must be in place. Cashiers must believe that you have a system of prevention, detection, and consequence. All three of those elements are important, and I like them in that order. Prevention. If we can't prevent it, we can detect it. And if we detect it because we didn't prevent it, there is a consequence to not being in the program, so to speak, within the numbers. All I look for is a cluster of cashiers. I don't care what your numbers are. I can't tell you what the national norm is for voids or refunds or anything, because there is no national norm. It's a stupid concept. And I don't mind telling you that. It's dumb, right? There's no natural norm, right? Other people don't have your coupons, right? They don't have your shopping mix. They don't have your high-low program. They might have a high-low program. They don't have your high-low program. So what goes through your front ends is different than what goes through any other store company's front ends or store's front ends. Look at your store as a cluster. Are all my cashiers in voids within a natural cluster, right? Do I have anybody outside the cluster? Go talk to them. It's pretty simple. Hey, Bob, I got a natural cluster of voids. Everybody's at like 1.2% of gross sales. Now, you did plenty of sales, but you're at 2.1%. How come? How come, Bob? That's what he's going to say. I don't know. Okay, well, look. Everybody else is like at 1.2. I don't know why you're at 2.1. I just know that I got to get it fixed. So I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'll keep an eye on your voids, okay? And you keep an eye on your voids and kind of know that I'm going to be watching to help you, right? So if there's anything, I mean, you are ringing everything up, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, I mean, you're not voiding stuff off for friends or anybody after you ring it up, are you?
Definitely.
Yeah, okay, good. Okay, well, fine. With all that said, I'll keep an eye on your voids, you keep an eye on your voids, and we'll see if we can get them down together, okay? They're right down the tubes, aren't they? Right? And nobody got threatened, nobody was angry, nobody was, you know, accused of anything, right? I just talked to Bob. That's all. Think, shrink, and talk. There's no right, there's no wrong. Just talk and don't accuse. And those numbers will come down, right? First we prevent, then when we detect, we talk and add consequence where necessary and appropriate. Right? You can do that kind of an interview, that kind of a 1 minute on the way to the time clock out to the register with any cashier at any time, and there's no labor to add. Right? You don't need labor. It's just talking to your employees. Right? Just let them know they're being monitored. Number one, cashiers must know that they're being monitored. They have to know that you are aware and not stupid. Not aware. You have to do that with consistency, right? You can't do it 1 week just because I suggested it, right? You have to put it on your store walk, talk to one or two or three cashiers every single week about something in their key performance indicators. You will slowly work your way through all 80 cashiers, right? But if that one cashier remains outside the cluster, then do whatever human resources dictates the proper approach is for dealing with that person who doesn't seem to come inside the cluster. Right? Or get loss prevention involved, or monitor, or get your cameras active because you all have cameras, right? That's when we can use our cameras for the detection model, right? And just watch at that point. But consistency is important.
For information about customized seminars for your store managers or for specific solutions to your loss prevention problems, contact Larry Miller personally at 602-448-8500 or visit retailcontrol.com for free tips, techniques, and lots more.